if Hebrewism only entailed, here's what I think my ancestors were, or something like that, that wouldn't be such a big deal. But it's like an anchor that weighs everything else down, and then when a person who was a professing Christian gets into it, they start off as, I'm a Hebrew, and next thing you know is, the Trinity is a Roman pagan concept that I can't abide by. It's as Daniel Dennett says about evolution, being a toxin or a toxic poison that affects everything. It's acid that corrodes everything, is his language. Hebrewism is like that with a person's belief structure as well. You can start off kind of innocent, I think I'm a Hebrew, and ends up denial of deity of Jesus and salvation by grace through faith alone.
I see you been in your Old Testament, excellent place to invest a bit, but what about the rest of it? What about by grace through faith to obtain residence in heaven, regardless of the vestiges of our heritage? Regardless of if Jesus was black, olive, or fairer skin, it's the person we worship, not the flesh he manifested in. So what if the J came later? The way you say the name is irrelevant. All that matters is what the message is, and we ain't preaching the same. My identity is in the one who defeated the grave. Galatians 3:28. It transcends color, creed, and estate. Only family of mine are those who keep in the faith. Think about it for a minute. If the enemy tried to conceal the truth the way you fit in, why would he go for pigment? See, devil knows the Bible, and the Bible is clear that your former identity will disappear when you're with him. And we can get to the main spade. Deuteronomy 28 ain't talking about the transatlantic slave trade. Look at verse 36. The Lord will bring you and your king, which you have appointed, to a strange place. Who's the king of West Africa brought to America? Where's the evidence for the geographical area? Sounds a lot like a confirmation bias. You're picking up the word and trying to stuff it in a bag you carry in. The scriptures reveal God, it's in a plain text. It ain't a DNA test. I wonder where your faith went. Turned your back on the bride, now your pride is the main threat. Truth is objective, it ain't always where your brain treads. You invalidate the cross with legalism. What Paul says, we ain't under law, cause the king is risen. Then you straw man Christians, like, we can get away with whatever we want, just as long as we believing in him. Come on, Eshon, you know that's wrong. In a witness of the spirit overthrows that bond. Lot of feelings, but ain't no facts drawn. Couple snakes up in your doctrinal garden, I'ma mow that lawn. Listen, I know it's easy to get lost in the weeds. Instead of closer, we get farther,
instead
it seems.
Closer, we get farther, it seems.
Then it all falls apart at the seams. That crooked lens will make it harder to see. It ain't about the Israelites, it's about the one who parted the sea. Sent the spirit and imparted his peace. Came to fulfill the law and defeat death. Now weep and break the jar at his feet. I know it's easy to get lost in the weeds. Instead of closer, we get farther, Then it all falls apart at the seams. That crooked lens will make it harder to see. It ain't about the Israelites, it's about the one who parted the sea. Sent the spirit and imparted his peace. Came to fulfill the law and defeat death. Now weep and break the jar at his feet.
Now weep and break the jar at his feet.